on the stage.
Yeah. Exactly.
So
it was
a very difficult thing to organize.
Yeah. No, it felt, and it, because of the quality of the design of the staging and the costumes, they really were fantastic.
Eva, can tell us maybe something about the costume design?
Yeah, well, working in the Teatro Real, it's a privilege, because you are there working with lots of people that know perfectly their place, their theater, and all the things they can offer you. So working with them, the lighting, all the costumes were fantastic, because you have a team working with you. I think we can use that. I think, do you don't like that? Well, perhaps you can choose among these 1,000 costume about whatever. So it's been a pleasure, really.
Wow. So yes, working with, because this is the constant or the permanent staff
of the Teatro Real.
Very
yeah.
professional.
And
very professional.
Also with the hair.
With the hair, of
course. They designed the hair for
we
the
were
moon.
Designing. I was with them. I told them what I wanted. So they were thinking, okay, well, and do you like these images? Do you like these? Do you prefer that? No, and we make a mixture between one of them.
And all of them with professionals saying, we can do this.
Of course.
Yeah. That's so exciting.
But not only they said, we can do it. They said, we can do it, and if you don't want, we can do it more times. So that it's also a privilege. And when we work in theater, you realize that it isn't very common. Because sometimes or people don't have time, or they don't know how to do that, or they don't have all the things they had to do all these things.
Yeah, the materials.
They were even changing the white of the costume for the moon. You know, changing the white. It's like we're changing a tone of whatever. Yeah, it's like.
Because the dress wasn't the same tone of the shoes. So they changed like two tones lower. The tone of the dress, it was like fantastic. I was there and it was so, I couldn't believe that. So much materials for you.
Well, and again, professional musicians, the mezzo-soprano also gave her...
The elf.
Yeah,
yes,
the elf. She's a mezzo-soprano, the pianist that you told, she's one of the best pianists in the country. So it was a very great emotion to have her, Rosa Torres Pardo. Yeah.
But it was a one-shot deal, one performance.
Yeah, only one.
It was also the week of the opera, no? Yeah. In that Teatro Real organized. Yeah. So it was something
special,
just one time.
And because of the 200th birthday of the theater, that was a very special week of the opera. That's why. We had the cantata play.
Now, not being there, and I didn't see any signs of the audience. Was the audience mostly adult, mostly children? What was the? Did you
adult? I think more. Was
more
adult,
but people. There were many children, and it was the first time that babies could enter to the theater.
Uh-huh. Yeah. It was full, completely full. The theater.
You feel it in the video, but I didn't know except through.
And at the end,
sold out,
and people at the end they were standing and crying. You know, it was so emotional.
Well, that's true. That some of them were the families of the children that were on the stage. So of course, it's very seeing your child singing in the stage of the Royal Theatre was something unbelievable, no?
Yeah,
but many people came also just for the pleasure.
Yeah.
No,
from my village, there was a bus, you know, coming.
Oh, wonderful.
Wonderful.
And will there be a chance of this being produced again? Do you
We hope.
Okay.
Perhaps not in the Teatro Real, but the idea is to move the message of the play, no? Because it's fantastic to perform in the Teatro Real, and it's very good that Teatro Real gives voice to all these teams and of the subject that usually are not in their stage, no?
Yeah.
But our idea, at least, is to move this so big work and this message to everybody. So all the plays we can do it.
Yeah.
Not all the plays in the world, because this is a very big production, but I mean, in Madrid there are many big theaters we can perform in.
Now, going back to your musical inspirations, what kinds of sound, how does nature how
inspired
did that, yes, inspire you? Because you hear moments of, there's a lot of dance feeling in the music. There's tangos, there's dissonance, but it's all very emotion. I don't know, emotive and powerful.
Mm-hmm.
What sort of inspirations did you find for?
Actually, Eva did the original story, mm-hmm. the tale, and then from that I was imagining musical atmospheres, and then sometimes I gave Eva the musics based on her story, actually, and we were at that time half living in the mountains of Madrid, in Braujos de la Sierra, so we had the mountains and the big trees around with the
great inspiration,
with happy animals, happy trees. So we had the inspiration from the mountains of the north, mountains of Madrid, actually, and then from that, actually, it came, and the wind, there's wind sound, and also for the moment of the area of Gea, of the earth moment, I got inspiration from the witch of the Little Mermaid's story, of Disney's Little Mermaid, Ursula, the witch, the bad woman. She sings a song that is very low, with a low voice, and since we had our Gea that had a very profound low voice as well, that was Rosa Torres Pardo, the pianist.
It was a very big surprise because it's the first time she sings
in
public.
In public, not only for friends.
Yeah, great job.
Yeah, great job. So then I got inspired from this deep singing in The Little Mermaid, witch, and then I composed the aria of Gea.
Well, let's listen to that aria of Gea.
Las especies, hay una que me duele, sois vosotros los humanos que me estáis haciendo daño. Me pintáis de gris el cielo con el humo de los coches para construir vuestras casas, destruís todos mis bosques.
Hate to interrupt that, but let's actually get a translation of some of those. So her blood, she's telling us her blood are the oceans. What else, Eva?
The oceans.
And her hair is the light, and her bones are the rocks of the earth.
Rocks.
And then this refrain, of course, is millions or thousands of animals inhabit my body. It's really, but the only animal, and she talks about the fish and the insects and the birds, but there's an animal that hurts her.
Yeah, the human. The human, and it's a shame we can listen the whole song, because this is a very political thing, because sometimes I like very much an Argentinian, well, she died, unfortunately. She's Marielena Walsh. She was a singer and composer and a writer. And she said something I was very interested in, that she wrote very much for children. And she said that you have to talk to the children seriously. I mean, perhaps in a way more, I don't know, lighter than the way you talk to the human being, to the adults, but that you have to talk to them about the things you want them to understand. So not only stupid things because they are children. So I wanted to talk to the children about the political items we have to solve.
No? You feel that. I mean, this is, as you said, the voice is deep. It's serious,
yeah.
And the message couldn't be clear. It also has that wonderful child effect of surrealism.
Yeah.
You know, when you start to think about the thousands of animals that inhabit
in a poetic, in a poetic in a way,
that's,
no?
Poetry.
Political is also poetic.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Can be, at least.
Mm. Well, I have to say we have to end our session today. I'm going to play more of this song to play out, but I wanted to thank you both and to hope that you will be returning to the studios in August?
Yeah, of course. We'll do
Wonderful.
Our best.
Sonia Mejías, Eva Guillamón, thank you so much for the cantata Somos Naturaleza.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
As promised, here is the rest of Gea's aria and the important political message of the cantata Somos Naturaleza. Gea addresses the human race and tells us, "It's you humans who are hurting me. You paint the sky gray with smoke from your cars. To build your homes, you destroy all my forests. Thousands of animals inhabit my body. They take care of me because they know I'm their food. They need me as much as I need them. Why do you like to lock a bird in a cage and hear it sing while killing its wings? Chickens, cows, and rabbits are tortured on farms so you can make money. Their flesh is just coins to you. At least now, you've learned the importance of the trees. They who clean the air every day with their photosynthesis. If you want to keep living on this planet Earth, you can't ever forget that you too are nature. Once you understand that the danger is real, we will all be able to breathe and live in peace." Then the narrator comes in, the moon, and winds up the tale. The photosynthesis strike almost finished off Gea and all the creatures living on her, including humans. But sometimes things change, and solutions are found where least expected. There's always a solution for everything. You just have to want to find it. The humans finally understood that the Earth belongs to no one. It belongs to all the beings that inhabit it. Because we are all pieces of the planet, parts of the chain. The Earth is our home. We are nature.
Pero entre todas las especies hay una que me duele. Sois vosotros los humanos que me estáis haciendo daño. Me pintáis de gris el cielo con el humo de los coches para construir vuestras casas. Destruís todos mis bosques.